Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Dana. I'm almost 26 years old, less than a week now, and I'm a certified personal trainer and fitness coach at Orange Theory. I also run their social media and I'm part-time assistant manager right now as well. So welcome to my channel. I post a lot about my own personal weight loss and fitness journey and also my job at Orange Theory because it's my whole life right now. I'm headed to work right now and I have not found like a decent place for my camera to sit in my car, so bear with me. I know you're a little slanted. We won't be here for long because I don't really like to film while I'm driving. You guys kind of saw a little bit of my morning routine. If you're interested in me doing a separate video on that, I will. Nothing crazy, honestly, nothing crazy at all. Today I work from 8 to 4. I'm thinking about taking the 4:15 after work, just depending on how I'm feeling. We did dry try last weekend and my body honestly is still a little sore. I'm still feeling like a little fatigued and just trying to catch up because the week leading up to dry try I was going through coaches training, so this nice little cold sore made his way to my lip after that extremely stressful week. So I'm just kind of coming down from like a lot that was going on last week, and I'm not sure if I'm gonna push my body today. If it feels right, then it's great, I'll do it, it'll feel good, but if I don't feel like my body can handle it, like I'm not gonna push myself. I figured I would do just like a couple days in my life, work days in my life. I guess today is Thursday and tomorrow's Friday. Friday is like my busy day at Orange Theory because I work at the front desk and I coach, like I do a double. So I open, so I'm there at 4:30 a.m. and I'm there till 11, go home, change, like take a nap, eat some food, and then I head back and I coach the evening classes. So I thought that'd be fun to take you guys along with me, kind of show you around the studio, what Orange Theory Fitness Coach does, like things like that. I've been rambling for a couple minutes. Most of you guys know my intros are a little too long. I love to chit chat with the camera, but this is just gonna be a couple days in my life. I might even film into Saturday because it's the members dry try. So the staff did their dry try last weekend, and then this Saturday, all the members come and do theirs. So I work Saturday as well this week. So it's just like a fun filled Orange Theory life that's going on this week. Go ahead and poke around on my channel. I'll have little clips that appear above with other videos of mine that you may want to check out if you haven't already. If there's anything on my channel that you don't see and you want to see, make sure to leave a comment and let me know. I love filming. I need to get back into being consistent on my YouTube channel. So anything and every kind of suggestion is appreciated. 7:44, I've got about 16 minutes to make it into work, and then we are headed in for a busy, fun-filled day. Guys, if this isn't me every single time, like, the gas station's right there, but I have 1 mile to go. I do this every freaking week. Trust me, I know that is not something to brag about. I know. I'm literally the worst. I'm still like that person that's putting $10 in at a time. Even though gas prices like did go down, I just feel like, I don't know, if I'm being completely honest, I never have enough money to fill my entire tank up. So that's where we're at. We're only 8 minutes late. Everything's fine. Okay, my nails are now finally falling off. They've been on for literally a month. Literally a month. I'm just feeling gross, but tomorrow I'm going to grab another pack of these and I'm gonna do them. I mean, like, literally they stayed for a month and they were $9. Okay, so I decided I'm gonna do my body scan today. It's recommended to do it like every 8 to 12 weeks. It's been 7 since my last one. But I will show you kind of like, basically, I think every Orange Theory has this. It's in your app. All of your like body comps will be in your app, and you can see I've done like a lot since we got it in January. My last one was Thursday, July 28th, and I was at 35% body fat, 60 pounds of skeletal muscle mass, and my weight was 168. I know that for a fact my weight's gone down, but I want to see if that has had a change in my body fat percentage, because yeah, it's great when you see the scale go down, but am I losing muscle or am I losing fat? Like, that's really important to me. It'll also calculate my metabolic rate, which will be good to know when I'm tracking my calories and macros, which I'm not doing as of right now. But going into like the fall season, I wanna try to be more focused on that, because that's when I usually start to eat and drink more. So When I did this in July, my metabolic rate was 1,719 calories, which is literally just the amount of calories that it takes my body to survive on a daily basis without physical activity. So keep that in mind. If you're eating under 1,200 calories a day, I highly recommend either talking to your nutritionist or doctor about that or getting on a scale like this, because you'll be surprised how many calories your body needs just to survive. Okay, if you're like going to work and working out on top of that, you should be eating I should be eating much more than 1,700 calories because I work out almost every day. So anyways, we're gonna go on this scale. Let's see what happens. From your telescope, take me on this journey home. I don't wanna wait no more. Lay me down behind the moon. Tell me you'll be on real soon. I don't wanna wait no more. We could be dancing in the stars. We could be floating all the way. As long as I'm safely in your arms, and it don't really matter where we stay. Don't pass, babe. Space makes me sad. Cause space makes me sad.
So the cool thing with this is it shows the new body comp history.
Okay.
It breaks it down into a total body fat.
Oh, this is my very first one ever.
Yeah. So you're down 4.6.
Yeah, I've lost a lot of muscle.
But you're also down almost 3% total body fat.
So my body fat has gone down like 3% since January.
Yeah.
But I've lost also a lot of muscle.
20 and a half pounds? Oh, shit.
Hell yeah. 20 pounds down since January. Hell yeah. It's been a while since I checked in, but I wanted to show you what I was eating as like my breakfast slash snack before I completely demolished the rest of it. I only have one apple slice left. But this is so good. It's literally like a honey Greek yogurt from Trader Joe's. I mix it with that cinnamon bun spread. And then also, I was working very hard on this new screensaver, and I'm gonna show y'all a little bit in our studio. So look how fun. It used to just be like a splat point up there, but I made it like a collage of our member pics. So now like in between classes, it shows like a fun little pic collage instead of that. So alrighty, I'm gonna get the vacuum and start vacuuming because right now is our midday break.
Is this thing recording?
Yeah.
Oh man. All right, well at least I know now.
It wasn't recording before. Hey, watch me clean. I'm OG vlogging on the phone because my camera died. But I'm about to take class at 4:15 and it's 4:08. So I just got off and I'm gonna change. I'm wearing this big, my favorite, Nirvana tee. It's literally from Target. The lighting in here is so shitty. Oh my god, I think I slept in it 2 nights ago, for being honest, so that's why it's a mess. And then these like cutie little shorts. I think these are from, oh, Dale and Athletica. And then I'm gonna wear my Hokas because they're my favorite running shoes. And then I just texted my roommates and begged one of them, like, somebody needs to get a drink with me because I just had like the most stressful day ever. So maybe that'll happen, maybe not. If not, I'll pour myself a nice big glass of wine when I get home. Okay, so I just got home and ate some dinner. Some leftovers that I had made yesterday. It was like tofu in general, soy sauce, and then threw it in with the Trader Joe's like veggie fried rice. And now I just changed and I'm throwing on some perfume. I'll just shower when I get home. I know that's kind of gross, but I wasn't even really that sweaty. But I'm gonna head to Paige's kickball game, and then we're gonna go to a bar I think after and like get a drink, which I think will be nice. Just some time with Paige because it's been a minute. And I just need like some friend time, you know? I don't know how much I'll vlog. You know me. It's very weird with the camera. But nevertheless, we're gonna have a good night. And we're gonna try to be home by like 9. Cause the girl's gotta be up at 3:45. I just realized I never talked to you guys about my workout. It was so good. Oh my god, this will literally never work. Like, I need something to put. my camera on. But my workout was actually really good. And like, I literally did not want to stay and work out. And I'm so glad I did because it felt amazing. But I had like a perfect pyramid, which that's going to mean nothing to those of you that don't go to OTF. But I can like kind of explain. You do wear a heart rate monitor during class and it tracks how many minutes are spent in each heart rate zone. And you want most of your time to be spent in the green zone. That's like your base pace, your home base where you feel comfortable. You're using 71 to 83% of your max heart rate. And it should be a pace that you could like hold for 20 to 30 minutes if you needed to. Anyways, I don't know. We also call it like your fat burning zone, which I don't love to like refer to it as that. But you want to spend the most time like between the orange and green, mostly green zones, in order for your body to keep up and be in like that aerobic like rate instead of the anaerobic rate. Am I saying that right? I don't feel like I'm supposed to be saying rate after it. Anyways, the kickball game was good. They won. I didn't vlog at all there, of course, but we are headed to a bar now just to grab like some food and drinks, and then I gotta go home at 7:15. Not bad. I want to be in bed. I would like love to be in my bed at 9, which I don't think is gonna happen because I still have to like pack some snacks and like get ready for my day. We're gonna try our best. We'll just let the record show. Okay, just let the record show that it is 8:56. So I did leave in time, and my intentions were to get in bed by 9, be home by 9. Okay. But Molly texted me, my new roommate, and she had a volleyball game at 8:45, and she was like, I'm just craving insomnia so bad, like, can we split some? And I literally cannot even tell you last time I had insomnia. Like, college, for sure. Like, I don't eat insomnia cookies, ever. Mainly because Bryce is allergic, like, very allergic to all nuts, so I try very hard to stay away from anything that has peanuts, nuts, cooked in peanut oil, come in contact with peanuts, like, all sorts of stuff like that. So we don't really eat a lot of cookies. Like, I don't know. I literally feel like I live out of a book bag now because it's like sometimes I sleep at Bryce's and I go to work, and then like at work, like I do my doubles, or like I change to get ready to go into class and things like that. I don't even know, guys. It's just like these last few weeks have been so stressful, but it's fine. It's worth it. It's paying off and I'm having fun. The best thing about this job, like, I love orangetheory because it is a fun job. Like, yes, of course, everyone hates like getting up early and like having to go to work. Like, oh, I have to go to work. Yeah, everyone has to go to work. But like, once I'm there, I'm thriving. Like, I do not feel like it is work when I'm there, especially when I'm coaching. Especially, that does not feel like work. Like, I'm excited to go back in for like the double, like the other half of my shift tomorrow because it's coaching. Like, that's so fun. I'm literally helping people like better themselves. I just feel like that's like very important and super cool. And anyways, yeah, I'm gonna go in and hopefully these cookies are ready, and then I'm headed to bed.
Bag is secure, and the time is now 9:15. I basically decided that I'm not going to be eating a cookie before bed because I get a little like, I don't know, I'm actually getting some water. I get a little bit weird. Does anybody else like smell the cups before? I don't know, I'm really weird, but I wanna make sure they're not gross. I get a little weird when I like eat a ton of sugar before bed, and I just don't wanna be anxious. So I think I'm just gonna wait and save to pack one for tomorrow. So right now I'm just getting some water before bed, and my new time, my new goal to be in bed by is 9:30. So I have 15 minutes to take off my makeup and just get myself together. And get everything ready. So I'm leaving the cookies there for Molly. Sorry, this is probably literally such a bad angle for me because I never walk around holding my camera like this, I feel like, ever. But my room is like literally trashed. My room's trashed. Let's lay out my clothes and get my book bag together for tomorrow. I'm gonna wear the same thing I wore like 2 days ago because it's my coziest, most favorite outfit. It's this big comfy crew from Nike. You guys, I wear these like, if you've been following me for a while, this is like literally all I wear in the fall and winter. Y'all know this. I have it in black and gray, and I'm gonna probably try to pick up some more colors either for Christmas or just like for myself, like come, I don't know, whenever they're like out again at Dick's. And I always forget what they're called. They're like a fleece cropped crew. Literally just, they're the best things ever. And so I wear this like big cropped crew with a pair of bikers. So I'm wearing that tomorrow because I feel cozy in it, and then I'll wear something different to coach because I have like a different uniform for coaching. But that's what I'm laying out to put on 4 o'clock in the morning. Okay, so my outfit for tomorrow is laid out, and for the most part, honestly, my room is pretty clean. Okay, this looks a mess because my bed isn't made, obviously. I need to find a spot for my keyboard. And over here, we have everything I just received from Shein. I forgot, I have like literally no time, I'm never home. I forgot I had to film a Shein haul. I had to film 2 TikToks, I think, and I also kind of wanted to do a sit-down YouTube video if I have the time. So that's what that pile of clothes is. Because I don't like to put anything away until I've filmed in it, because I'll just forget. Okay, the time is now, 9:21. So we have 9 minutes to get a good show going. I do want to take my makeup off. Oh, let me show you guys what I've been using to take my makeup off. And if you've ever tried this, or if you have any, like, any words about it, any suggestions, positive or negative, please send them my way. My aunt got this for me. It came in, like, a pack of 4. And I think it's called like Erase Your Face or something. I got it for Christmas, like literally last year. They come, they're like, this one's kind of dirty, like I need to throw it in the washer. But you literally just wash them like with your dirty clothes. And I got 4, like I said. So I have like a black, a pink, a blue. This one shows your makeup like a lot. The black one obviously doesn't. But I also noticed the black pills like a lot on your face. But literally, okay, I'll do it right now in front of you. This is like literally not sponsored at all. I'm just gonna show you. So. Here's my face before, and then you literally just wet this with nothing else on it, okay? So now it's damp. That like didn't even take 2 minutes, I feel like, and I feel so good. So other than that, you probably would also wanna like wash with soap or whatever, but if you guys have been here for a while, you know, I literally don't wash my face. I know. It literally just freaks me out more. Like, I haven't found a good face wash that works good for me. Like, I only wash my face in the shower. I know, so gross. And yeah, I worked out with makeup on and then I didn't take it off till now. I know, I'm disgusting.
All right, y'all. My hair is looking kind of atrocious because I never got blonde shampoo. So it's like really, really bleached in the front now. I'm not loving it. But anyways, yeah, so I'm going to bed now. It is 9:26.
Good morning, friends. It is 4:09, and I love my job, and we're about to head out. I probably didn't fall asleep till like a little after 10, and I talked to Molly a little bit when she got home from her game, so definitely did not go to bed at like a great time. I did try my best, and that's all that matters.
I have to do some cutouts for dry try. So I have like the rosters printed for each heat, and then I wrote everyone's name on these flats and laminated them. You can't really tell if they're flats because I haven't cut them out yet. Once I get them out, I'll show you. And then we're gonna tape them to the rowers so that everybody, when they come in and they like get on their rower to start out for dry try, they have like a little, they have like a little name tag. We're already in the 6:15 class. It's 6:50 now, so almost time for the 7:30 class. I have been listening to Coach Frank coach these classes because I coach the same one later, and I'm also taking a look at the template and just kind of like studying it, taking notes on like what I want to say, cues, things like that, since I probably won't have time to take class today. So I'm listening in for that, taking notes, cutting out these splats, doing check-in, all the good things. Okay, so this is what the splats look like now that they're like cut out. So they're gonna go on the rowers, like I said. I just ran into Walgreens. I'm so freaking hungry right now. All I've had today is a coffee and Teddy Grahams. And that's just not smart, guys, it's not. But I needed to get new nails, obviously, y'all know that. So I picked up these, like acrylic, natural looking ones. They're different than the ones I had, because the ones I had were like French tip, but these are just white. And I got like the real short ones, so hopefully I don't have to like cut and file them like I did last time, because they were way too long last time. I don't know if I showed you guys this yet in this vlog, but this is so freaking good. My friend Emma introduced me to like the recipe. It's just Trader Joe's fried rice, and then I cut up some tofu and threw some General Tso's like sauce on it. I definitely already talked to you about this because I remember thinking, like being afraid that I was saying General Tso's wrong. And I've had so many leftovers. Like I think this is my 3rd time eating it, and I definitely have enough for like another bowl of it. So I'll probably
like take it to eat tomorrow.
Okay, I just got here and I'm running like kind of late. Like it's literally 3:45 right now and I'm supposed to be here at 3:45. And I wanted to show you, like I listened to my coaching playlist the whole way here just to like kind of prepare, and it's on Spotify and it's like open. So if you search my name, I'll leave my Spotify link down below if you like want to listen to it, if you need like a good cardio playlist. I'm going to try to show you around the studio and like as much as I can about coaching when I'm in there, but right now I'm kind of in a rush, so maybe in between classes.
Okay, so I'm getting ready for my second class. I have two classes today, 4:15 and 5:30. I'm all mic'd up and ready to go. I've got my timer, my mic pack with the mute button and everything, and then I wear a headset here. And I'll probably show you the studio once class is over. I only have like 3 minutes till class starts, but I had two intros last class. Just wanna make sure this is muted, that'd be so awkward. New members, trying to get them in and get them pumped about the workout. They all did amazing and had like a great time. So they're up at the front desk signing up now, and I have another class to go. So I'm looking forward, I love doing Friday nights, I think it's so fun. Okay, literally that second class went so well. Like after I get the hang of the first, like the groove in the first class, I feel like the second one just goes so like easy breezy and it felt good. But I am gonna give you a tour of the studio really quick before I head out for the night. So we're setting up for a dry try tomorrow. This literally looks so cute, Adi did it. And then when you come into the studio, we have all of our rowers set up on the left hand side, and then the weight floor is in the back. On this TV, it's like the VVA, so it's like the visual aid system where you can kind of see the workouts being done by professionals once the coach walks away from you. There's 12 stations at each of them, and then here are our treads. The TVs up there are where you keep track of like your splat points and stuff in class. But right now I am just getting all of these splat points set up for the first heat of dry try. So the 7:30 or the 7 o'clock heat, when they come in, all of these little splat points are going to be sitting like on their rowers by the numbers. So that's like a really cute touch. I'll show you when I'm done. They look pretty cute. You can't really see anyone's name unless you get up close to them. No one's on for this heat. But I think it was like a nice touch to just like, you know, come in and like have a little name tag by your station. I'm about to lock up and head out for the night. Have to be here at 6:30 tomorrow morning. I don't know yet if I'm vlogging or not tomorrow, because I get really weird about my camera in front of everyone. I do think I'll vlog tomorrow because I think it's important for you guys, you know, who are interested to just kind of like see, get a little glimpse into it. All right, I'm gonna clean up, lock up, and then I'm headed home. I think I'm gonna go out for a little bit with my big again. Good morning, it's dry try day. It's after 7 now, and Coach Rink is demoing the weight floor, getting everyone warmed up. We are headed into our first heat. I'm accounting for my friends Carrie and Olivia. So I'll count their row time, their time on the weight floor, their time on the tread, and then total all together. We'll see how they do. Lots of people's first time today. A lot of people are nervous. The nerves are settling in, but everyone's gonna do great. I'm so excited.
Rowers, well then it's time we kick off our first heat. Try.
Woo-hoo!
2022 in 3, 2, 1,
let's go. Let's go.
To hold tight, don't need a love that's all mine, but sometimes I just want somebody to talk to. Someone that's on my mind. I want something that's all cool, and it don't waste my time. Yeah, I just want somebody.
All right, everyone, we are home. We are home. We made it through the day. Honestly, really quick, like so I don't get too sappy, I just really love my job. Like I really, just today I experienced, I mean I've done like a dry try before where like I was there, obviously present, but coaching it, and like I really wanted my camera to be in there while I was coaching, but there's just so much going on. Like I wanted to see if one of the other staff members could like film me a little bit while I was coaching. I didn't film any of that, not a lot of filming today, but you did get to see a little bit about what it looks like. And in this vlog, you kind of got like an introduction to my studio and stuff, which I think is really cool. And I can definitely do more OTF vlogs if you guys are interested. But yeah, I just feel like this is exactly what I'm supposed to be doing. And coaching it, I coached the 12:30 heat, and honestly, like, it's so different than just being in the room because you are over the mic. If you cannot tell, I have no energy. Like my social battery is completely dead and I cannot wait to hop in that bed right now and take a fat cat nap. But I just feel like the people that we surround ourselves with at this at this location, and it's just amazing. These people just, they push themselves every single day. I watch themselves push themselves even harder, and I get to be like a part of that, and I get to coach them through it, and I think it's so cool. Like, who the heck wants to work 12 days in a row? Not me. Like, I'm not even gonna stand here and lie to you. Like, I do not want to go there 12 days in a row. Are you kidding me? Who would? Who would want to work 12 days in a row? But the fact that I get to go, I'm hot. And, like, be with these people that I love and, like, coach them through, get them one step closer to their goals every day, like, is just really cool. And I really, really hope that this passion that I have for it, like, never dies down, because it's really cool. Like, when I go to coach, I absolutely love being there. It's so fun. And I just love, like, being a part of these people's journeys. It's such a cool feeling. So anyway, I hope you got a little taste into OTF in this vlog. And anything else that you want to see, leave it down below. Let me know. I'm going to take a nap. I don't think I'll be seeing you again in this vlog, so I'm going to sign off here. I appreciate you clicking on this video and checking it out, whether you're a new subscriber or an old subscriber. I love you all, and I'm so happy that you are here with me today. I hope that you continue to stick around. Make sure to hit that sub button if you haven't already. I'll catch you guys in my next video. Bye.